If you thought Chris Brown's Jihad on Good Taste was an absolute Twitter fail, you haven't seen anything yet. Welcome back to the worst thing I ever posted. Now, it's not unusual for rap stars to wax poetic about their use of a certain stress-relieving substance. But unlike Bow Wow, most rappers have the sense to exercise a little discretion. At number four, it's Bow Wow and his tipsy tweets.
What don't I have in store?
Little Bow Wow, he's not so little anymore. He tweets, he drives a Lamborghini, he drinks, and sometimes he does all three at once.
Face numb, I'm whipping the Lambo. Tipsy as F word.
First of all, kind of a humble brag.
They definitely need to make an app for celebrities that drink too much and think it's okay to let us know about it on Twitter. Like, we could call it Shut the App.
I'm up. Oh, damn, why drive the Lambo? Chris might have to drive after the next stop.
I don't know why he's letting Chris Brown drive. He may hit something.
Oh, those Duke boys, they're at it again.
Little Bow Wow, I was such a fan back in the day, man. What happened? Just put on your old junior high clothes and just tighten up, bruh.
Things that you should never, ever tweet. I'm gonna dump my pregnant girlfriend, probably. Does anyone have any meth? Seriously considering robbing this bank right now. Picture of bank.
The next day, Bow apologized for the tweet, calling it, quote, stupid and immature. Okay, just because we said stupid and immature doesn't mean we're going to use that as a segue to Justin Bieber. But here we are. Everyone knows that Biebs is the king of the selfie. From his multi-tats to his epic abs, the pint-sized superstar loves to post pics of his favorite things.
I may not like his music or anything he stands for, but I gotta admire the guy's gym selfies. He's really cut for an 11-year-old girl.
Jailmate. Would describe that.
Can't take a gym selfie if you have no muscles. Forgot the muscles in the photo.
That's the kind of that'll get us attacked by North Korea.
But there's one boastful blunder that makes our list at number three.
So on a visit to the Anne Frank house, Justin Bieber left a note in the logbook. Anne was a great girl. Hopefully she would have been a believer.
Only Justin Bieber would make the Holocaust about Justin Bieber.
Justin Bieber's going through it and he needs a grip.
The Anne Frank Museum posted the comment on their Facebook page.
Newsflash, she would be a f***ing believer too.
Right, because Anne didn't have anything better to do other than write a diary and worry about whether the Nazis were gonna come take her away.
Dear diary, I hope that someday, maybe 70 years from now, a tender-faced man-child singer from Canada will come rescue me from this hell I'm living in.
But even Canada doesn't want him back. That's what's happening.
Give Justin a break. If you were a teen heartthrob with suitcases full of cash and hot girls throwing themselves at you 24/7, you'd be an ass too.
Happily, Amanda Bynes is on the road to recovery. But when she went all Britney a while back, no one could turn away. At number two, Amanda's viral vitriol.
Well, I feel like karma is important.
Bynes has posted plenty of bathroom selfies, but it's when she starts typing that things get wonky.
Her tweets are what get me out of bed in the morning.
Amanda Bynes tweeted, if you look good, words can't hurt you.
Amanda Bynes is a truth teller, and I respect everything she has to say.
I want $1 million a year for having my mind read and privacy stolen.
Amanda Bynes is a poet. She knows something that we don't.
At Rihanna, Chris Brown beat you because you're not pretty enough.
Amanda, Chris Brown did not beat Rihanna because she's ugly. He beat her because she was standing in front of him.
But one tweet that truly takes the cake was a simple request to R&B singer Drake.
My favorite Amanda Bynes tweet has to be, I want Drake to murder my vagina.
I want you to murder my vagina is pretty much the greatest pickup line of all time. I mean, it would definitely work on me.
It's like a board game, you know? Where's it gonna happen? Like, in the study with a candlestick? Intrigue.
I don't know what murdering a vagina means, but I'm certain I have never done it.
I'm pretty sure Drake would not murder her vagina with a 10-foot pole.
If Drake murders anything, that's good, because it'll finally give him a little bit of street credit.
Soon after, she tweeted that Drake was ugly. It's like, girl, are you vagina blocking your own self?
Coming up, we'll bear it all when we get to the absolute worst post ever.
You're not a photographer. You're a drunk person in the bathroom.
Yep, it's gonna get weird.
I just wanna put some ointment on there, heal it up.
So far, we've seen pot-smoking singers, bloody faces, and Amanda Bynes basically lose it on everyone. But there's one online trend that gets our vote for the worst thing I ever posted. Be honest. Who hasn't stood in front of a mirror and taken a selfie before? Or 150?
I think you should not selfie more than twice a day, especially if you're in the same outfit.
Get that angle as high up as possible. I'm not talking arm length. I'm talking like Hubble Space Telescope. I want people to see a little peach pixel really thin.
There's a certain angle where it's like good and then lawnmower accident victim. Totally okay, super hot, really awful.
Like, what are smartphones for if not naked selfies?
But stars take this bad idea supernova. At number one, we give you a scandalous assortment of nude celebrity selfies.
I'm not gonna sit here and tell celebrities not to take naked selfies, okay? It's pretty much the only thing I have.
Singer Hayley Williams blamed a hacker for leaking this topless twit pic. You'd think a computer geek would have better things to do than obsess over boobs. Oh, right.
Yeah, Hayley Williams said she got hacked. I'm impressed that a hacker managed to delete her shirt.
It's like two little mosquito bites. I just want to put some ointment on there, heal it up.
Bad? Yes. Worst? Not even close. Shocking selfies aren't just Haley's jam. Model Adrienne Curry went overly artistic in this overexposure.
If you're gonna post a naked selfie of yourself on Twitter and cover one nipple,
that's like wanting to f somebody from the Brady Bunch and the middle brother instead of Greg.
Oh, wait, she married that one. Boom.
But this celeb takes the naked cake, hats, and everything else off to Geraldo Rivera for proving that bad judgment knows no age.
Okay, so it's like 1:30 in the morning, and Geraldo Rivera tweets a picture of him in his towel and says 70 is the new 50.
Geraldo is looking pretty good, but he's like, check me out, I'm ripped, I'm drunk, call me. When I saw Geraldo's naked chest and upper penis, I thought, an old Hispanic man? I'm into it. Wait, he's 70? Oh, I take it back, but also I don't.
Put a filter on that. Filters are your friend.
Why is your bathroom messed up, Geraldo? Get it together, buddy.
His only response is that he blames tequila. Although I have pissed the bed multiple times due to tequila, so I get that.
Naked selfies are the worst thing to post online because nobody wants to see your naked butt, and you're leaving nothing to the imagination. You're putting it all out there on Twitter, literally all out there.
Hey, thanks, Paulie D. Words to live by. And there you have it, the worst thing I ever posted. Hopefully, this cautionary tale will teach you to think twice the next time you want to hit send. Yes, we're talking to you, Justin Bieber. This season.